So you found the Quran in its words, letters, verses still preserve and still exist. It's not a law that you change by majority vote or that you go from country to country. Now we are in Arabia, you pray for rak'at. America will make it 3 rak'at. No. 4 rak'at everywhere. Hijab is hijab wherever you go. You are Muslim in China or in America or in Arabia, doesn't matter. Okay? It's not changing. And this bring about unity. Bring about equality. Bring about brotherhood and sisterhood wherever you are. You go to China, you pray behind the imam, after walad dalil, you have found everybody saying Ameen, and they say it in Arabic. Doesn't matter if Arabic is their language or not, everybody would say what? Ameen. Here is, say, Sami'a Allahu liman hamidah. All the imams, wherever they are, when they read, they say, Sami'a Allah. So you can see the beauty of it. The unity, wherever. Okay? Not somebody saying good morning, and somebody saying bonjour, and somebody say, Hayyak Allah. Everybody say, Assalamu alaikum. A greeting all over, wherever. So this is the beauty of Islam, the value of Islam. The beauty of this Islam, it doesn't split your life. It doesn't make your life 2 pieces. In the mosque, you are a Muslim. In the street, you are Abd al-Dunya. No. That means we don't have a church and government. Okay? We don't have a church and government. That in the church, you worship in God, whatever way you want. When you go outside, we run in the show. No. A'ilahum ma'allah? Is there any other God beside Allah? There is no any God. In al-hukmu illa lillah. Amara alla ta'budu illa iyah. Thalika ad-din al-qayyim. The deen, the total submission is to Allah. In the mosque, in the government, in the White House, in the Green House, wherever it is, majority vote, minor, everything. No, we have one thing called Al-Islam. We'll govern you in the mosque, in the street, in any place. You found Islam goes with you. You found that this deen also, the beauty of it, it doesn't split your life to be dunya and akhirah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dunya and made the akhirah. And made the dunya for you to prepare for the akhirah. And make the dunya to be mazra'a lil akhirah, to be a field to plant. And after this in the akhirah your harvest. You get the fruit. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَابْتَغِي فِيمَا أَتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. That seek the hereafter by all means that Allah gave it to you in this dunya. So if Allah give you money, let the money away for to achieve Jannah. Give in sadaqah, give in charity, give to the poor and the needy, assist the mosque. Okay? He said, وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا أَتَاكَ اللَّهَ الدَّارَ الْأَخِرَةِ. And don't forget about your share of the dunya. You find Islam say what? رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْأَخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً. Okay? Oh Allah, grant us the best, the good of this life. And also what? The good and the best of the hereafter. So Islam didn't come to tell you, you could not have a wife. No, you could not have a car. No, what are you talking about? They say, yes, you can, but get it in halal. You find Islam saying, no boyfriend, no girlfriend, but you can get married. You see? He giving you a clean and a pure alternatives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala attends what's good for you. Other than this, people attend something to destroy you, to ruin you. Okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't forbid you to have a husband, to have a wife. Okay? You want a wife to such a degree, even made marriage to be equal to half of your religion. If Allah bless you with a wife that fears Allah, a righteous woman, so Allah had enabled and assist you with half of your religion, so fear Allah in the other half. You see how Islam regards marriage? Okay? But you found, when you go to man-made, found something different. You found adultery, fornication, boyfriend, girlfriend, nakedness, dating, all kind of haram. And after these people get sick, and after these people have a sexual disease, and after this try to find a remedy and a cure for the illness, how? If you disobey Allah. You see, Islam has given you a protective message, methods from day one, and say, وَلَا تَقْرَبُ الزِّنَا إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشَةً وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا. Don't come near adultery. Anything that eventually will bring you to this haram relationship, don't come. Music, privacy between male and female, okay? Dating, name all these things, boyfriend, girlfriend. Islam say do not come near this, because it can lead you to fall into fornication and adultery. And it says this is an evil, bad way. We see it today with those people who talking about they've been modern, and they've been, you understand, they understand everything, and they see there's nothing wrong with this, nothing wrong with that, because their God is their logic. Their God is their mind. Allah said, أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَهَ أَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَهَ هَوَاهُ وَأَضَلَّهُ اللَّهُ عَلَى عِلْمٍ. Do you see the one who takes his logic, his mind, his opinion to be a God instead of Allah? How you can be a winner? Your mind is limited. You know, my brothers and sisters, your vision is limited. Doesn't matter how old you are. Your hearing is limited. You want me to prove this? Tell me what's going on in South Carolina. Can you hear it? Why nobody answering? You guys think? I told you don't eat dinner before the lecture. Nobody awake. Anybody awake? Can you know what is going on outside? Forget about South Carolina. Do you know what's going on outside? Those two brothers standing outside the other door. What's it? No, sir. This is mine. Thank you. And I'm holding this with it. I'm sorry. Thank you. Please forgive me. So, why you don't hear the people outside? Okay. You are limited in your language. You're limited in capability. You're limited in ability of eating. You are limited in everything. It's true or not? How much you can eat? How many chicken? One? A whole chicken? Two chicken? Three chicken? Tell me how much. Why not? You're limited. How far you can see? A mile? 2 miles? 3 miles? I'm asking you, what's going on after 5 miles? You could not tell me. Is it because you're blind? No. Because your vision is limited. So also your mind is limited. But the one who is not limited is Allah. The one who is not limited is Allah. So let the one who is not limited make Sharia for you. But people are limited. Today you say you can marry a man, or a woman can marry a woman. You can be a gay, you can be a lesbian, you can be understand boyfriend and girlfriend, and all these things, they're trying it. Now we know the value of Islam, because Islam told us that it's serious. And now we see the result. Now they have sexual disease. Islam summarizes it in one word. Sa'a sabila. A bad end, evil end. Okay? AIDS. And they could not find, even with all this technology, they could not find the proper solution for AIDS. And you wait, see what's more going to happen when you try to live by your own methodology and your own way. So we as a Muslim, we say Alhamdulillah, we thank Allah for this deed, because He shows us, He gave us magnifying glass, He gave us ability to understand and to see and to hear what we could not hear with our ears, what we could not see with our eyes. How? Because when we read the Quran, we know it's from Allah. قُلْ أَأَنْتُمْ أَعْلَمُ أَمِ اللَّهِ. Say to them, O Muhammad, are you no better or Allah? لا إله إلا الله. Who knows better? The totality of mankind, if get together, they could not be anything besides the knowledge of Allah. And if the people have so much knowledge, they only know what is happening now, or what is the possibility of these experiments. But can somebody tell you what's going to happen the next day, or next month, or when is the day of judgment, or when you understand this and that? So the deen is from Allah, and we say what? Allahu Akbar. So everything is a small, but Allah is the greatest. So what comes from Allah is greatest, and nothing can match in with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given. This deen, the beauty of it, and the value of this deen, that is, have tawazun, balance. The deen didn't say to you, you have to sit in the mosque every day. Neither the deen said to you, everything you work hard and work like a machine, because you have a family. There is a balance. Yes, sister, go ahead, I'm listening. I promise you, I'm not going to give lecture until you finish. Oh, now I understand. No, leave them, akhi. Now I know what they're doing. They're translating to each other. Inshallah, I will advise the administration of the mosque to make two rooms, sister's room. One for those who like to listen to the lecture, and one room with no speakers inside, so those who would like to carry. You know what? You know why is this happening? Because the Muslims, they love each other so much, and they barely come to meet each other. So whenever they get together, they want to talk. They want to socialize. And this is our problem. We see, keep our wives away from each other. We keep the brothers away from each other. Why we could not come to the mosque and sit and talk? Love each other, caring for one another. So what happened? The only time they come when they, what you call batlak lak or whatever. What do you call this? Batlak? Batlak. Huh? Batlak. What? It's a dinner, all right. There's a food, and after this and this, especially if it's spicy, and now they need to talk. They need to socialize. But anyway, the beauty of Islam has tawazin. Like what? Say, inna li rabbika alayka haqqa. Wa inna li badanika alayka haqqa. Wa inna li zawjika alayka haqqa. Wa inna li zurika alayka haqqa. فَعْطِ لِكُلَّ ذِي حَقٍ حَقًّا. What's this saying? It say, indeed, Allah has a right over you. And your body has a right over you. And your wife has a right over you. And your guests and visitors have a right for you. So give everyone their right time, right portion. So we don't have something called masjid and this it, or a school and this it, dunya and this it, akhirah and this it. We say no, balance yourself. This is a beauty. Islam is so beautiful, my brothers. Islam is so great, my sisters. Anything in Islam is value. And we have to love this Islam. Why we have hard time to pray? Why we have hard time to cover and have hijab? Why we have hard time to stay away from riba and usury? Because the love of the dunya is more than the love of the deen. This is it. وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. How much you love, how much you're going to give. So if Allah and the deen of Allah became your priority, now everything would be good. If you make the scale of the dunya more than the akhirah, or you give all the love that you have for the material thing on the cost of the akhirah, now you distribute. So Islam came to tell you, Allah has a right over you. Islam came to tell you, فَإِذَا قُدِيَتِ الصَّلَاةِ فَانْتَشِرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. How many times Allah said that you have to make hajj? One time. And even he said, لِمَنْ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. Subhanallah. If you don't have the means, you are not obligated to make hajj. So you can see the beauty of Islam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the woman to cover from head to toe when she go outside of her house, not because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have something against you. Allah want to purify you. Allah want to purify the society. Allah want a clean society, not adultery society. Allah wants you to cover your beauty. I saw something in YouTube. And was a small segment, the smallest segment that I ever saw. And was no talk. I saw two pieces of candy. This is a clip. Listen to the da'wah. Two pieces of candy, lollipop. One is still in the wrap. You call it wrap? Wrapped up. And one that they took the paper out. And the ants... And the flies come on the, which one?
The one is naked.
The one is naked. And the one that is wrapped, nothing on it. So the design of a woman taking her hijab, or the legislation of a woman to be covered, is for these flies not to fall in you. So you don't be something cheap. When you go to the flea market, you found everything in the table. But when you want to go buy a piece of gold, you go to Main Street and you have to push the button like this and it opens for you. And when you come inside, you say, I want to see this ring. Now he comes with the keys, open, and they slide the window and they bring it and show it to you. And you have the camera. Why? Because the value of the gold. So a woman so value her privacy, her nakedness. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given her this hijab. But no, we want to be free. Free of what? You mean you want all these flies to fall in you. And all these things, you understand, to come on top of you. So you became a cheap and free for everybody to look and touch and talk. And believe it, the one who is looking today, he's trying to touch you tomorrow. And the one who touch you tomorrow, he's going to touch. It's not going to be a limit, it's going to stop. So when we love Islam, when we respect Islam, we know that everything in Islam is for purpose, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yuridu bikum al-yusra wa la yuridu bikum al-usr. The beauty of Islam, that it gives answer to any question that comes to your mind. Why I am here? Where I am going? What is going to happen? You don't find anybody, any society, any constitution, any bylaws can answer all your questions. Al-Islam is the only book, the book of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam will answer all your questions. From where and to where and when and why. Anything you want to know. Why I've been created? وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I had created jinn and mankind only for purpose of worshiping me. He gave you the answer. What's going to happen in the grave? What's going to happen on the sirat? What's going to happen if I be disbeliever? What's going to be happening if I'm disbelievers? What is going to happen tomorrow? If it's been decreed? Is it just known? Is it happened? Why is this calamity fall on me? Allah purify you. Allah cleans you from your sins. Allah is testing your iman. Any question will come to you, you find it in Islam. You found the Islam giving you the answer about something very important. And a challenge. Nobody else can make the challenge. Because you don't know the future. How you can challenge somebody? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuhan nas, in kuntum fi raybin min al-ba'ath, fa inna khalaqnakum min turab, thumma min nutfatin, thumma min alaqah, thumma min mudghatin mukhallaqatin wa ghayri mukhallaqah, لنبين لكم ونقر في الأرحام ما نشاء. O people, he did not say O believers, say O mankind, because Islam came to address Muslims and non-Muslims, black and white, male and female. O mankind, if you are in doubt concerning resurrection, because do you know if the people believe in resurrection, life will change. When people are scared, say speed limit 60. Okay? And they're telling you there is a camera, there is a police, there is all the things. Even if you're speeding, you'll be what? You'll be nervous and you try to look right and left. You try to understand all the things. So Islam bought something to monitor you. A camera, a recording, but it's in you and in everyone, our conscience. Our conscience. بَلِ الْإِنسَانُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ بَصِيرًا وَلَوْ أَلْقَى مَعَاذِيرًا. Everybody is well acquainted and well aware about himself. لَا أُقْسِمُ بِالنَّفْسِ اللَّوَّامَةِ وَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِالنَّفْسِ اللَّوَّامَةِ. Why? Why a cat that you give it food sits and eats there? And why the wild cats back home, not here, okay, that when it snatch a fish, takes the fish and run away? Because even cats, animals, they have conscience. They will know what is lawful, what they got it halal, or what they got it as haram. Allah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم. اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة الصلاة القائمة آت محمد الوسيلة والفضيلة وابعث اللهم مقام محمد الذي وعدته. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I don't want to bore you with my talk. I only give the introduction for the subject, and inshallah we will give the lecture in the 2020 when I come again. So please, I'm sorry, I don't want to bore you, but all what I want to tell you, we have a great ni'mah, a great blessing that Allah give us, which call al-Islam. I don't have to sit and remind you about everything. Go read the Quran and see the cure. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ. The Quran is nothing except a healing and mercy. Love the Quran, love the Sunnah, love the Deen, so make things much easier for you in this life. I was expecting to give you the whole lecture, but maybe we'll finish by Fajr if I try to finish the lecture. But believe it or not, If we put a trust in the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, as much as we give a trust to this medicine given by a doctor, our life will change. Our life will be much better than we are. If we can give Allah this trust, that we give it for some medicine been written by a human being, and sometimes it may be the doctor giving you the right medicine, but it doesn't work with your own body. It can work with somebody else's body. Okay? Not I'm trying to condemn doctors. Okay? He can be giving you the right medicine, but because you develop trust that this man is a doctor and what he's giving you is going to help you, if we develop this to our deen, our life will change. Our life will be much better than we are. Wallahi, this is a great ni'mah that Allah gave it to us. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati wa raditu lakum al-Islam deena. Today, I completed the religion for you and perfected my favor upon you, and I'm pleased with Islam as a way of life for you. How Allah can be pleased with something that have deficiency? How Allah can be pleased with something that's not complete? How Allah can give you a medicine that is not going to work? No way. So trust in Allah and put your trust in Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the good of this life and the good of the hereafter. Thank you for listening. Thank you for being here tonight. And inshallah, like I said, this was the introduction. I didn't give the lecture yet. But you have two choices. 1-2 months from now, or 2020, inshallah, that if I'm still alive, you can invite me, we can talk about the lecture. Jazakumullah khairan for being here tonight. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you all. And don't forget, tomorrow we have a janaza workshop. And you should be acquainted. We are not going to talk the janaza only, we'll talk about this. We're going to talk about this also, okay? To wake up a little bit and be more conscious about Allah. But this something need to be known and the practice in the community, how to prepare the janazah. Because we, all of us, going to die. And all of us responsible to prepare. And if nobody in the community know, or only few people, and sometimes they are not available, is going to be something very embarrassing before Allah, before the people. So please try to come and try to benefit, inshallah. We're going to give you details and answer your questions about the janazah, the burial, what is sunnah, what is not sunnah. Inshallah, we'll try to make it understand something beneficial for you. Like I said, I made some sacrifice to be here tonight, believe me, okay? I'm an elderly man. By the way, congratulations to me. I'm 65 now. So I am, what you call this, retired. I'm retired, but I'm about to start, inshallah. For whatever more time Allah give me, I am here for this deen, for this da'wah. So I'm telling you that we need really to do investment with Allah. Don't be miser with your time for Allah. So I made some sacrifice to be here. So please, can you make some sacrifice tomorrow and try, inshallah, to be with us, okay? So we can learn something, inshallah. If nothing, at least you be here with each other, see each other, get the opportunity, can see each other, and the sisters sit with each other and talk, you understand, after the lecture, not during the lecture. And the kids can be playing also, not during the lecture, but before the lecture. Thank you again, and if there is any questions, I'll be available officially or unofficially. So by the mile with you, sit with you, sit with you, sit with you. Okay. As long as somebody have a question, I'll be glad to sit and answer your question. But I'm not asking you that you have to stay after Isha. If you have a question or you want to learn from the questions, I'll be available. Doesn't matter. I didn't come here to shopping. I came here, you understand, to be with you. And by the way, Brother Sabri, Mutahir Sabri, okay? I don't know if some of you know him. He was here recently and he visited you many times. Both of us in the same mosque, okay? For the last at least 20 years, okay? So he's sending his salam to you, okay? So inshallah, like I said, I came here to be with you. So I appreciate if you try to spend some time with me, inshallah. I'm an old man, but you are, most of you, young. So make the sacrifice, okay? Try to match. Try to compete with me. Show me that you're younger than me, okay? Jazakumullah khairan. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.